This is what should be in a UAC Atlantica master level. So when we start out, there's a huge wide open area. I think there should be cacodemons, pain elementals, and yeah, even some blood makers. See, UACA is the only map in Tag 1 to not have spirits and blood makers, so you know they're going to have to be in the master level. Now, being that this is such a wide open area, there's a lot of cacos you can Meathook fling off of, and really some Meathook nodes will be sweet, but I know that Tag 1 isn't able to do that. So you can have a bunch of ground super heavies that are taken on the ground level with the air raining in from the sky, and just having this outdoor arena would be perfect that way. Especially having an upper and a lower level, you could really play off that aerial attack move there and really just push it on the ground as well. So when you go into the inside area with the blue key, you have to have some area denial enemies there. Having Cyber Mancubi there is really good because they block off those sections of the level that they don't want you walking on top of. And being it's such like a tight, tiny space, that really makes it a lot tougher. So we definitely need some Cyber Mancs on the inside. And you know, considering going upstairs, downstairs, an Arch Vial would be nice. Same thing with the outside actually, because then you have to hunt him down. Is he up? Is he down? But it's got to be fun no matter which way you go about it. So Cyber Mancs, Archfile, what else should be there? I think a lot of things like that. Dread Knights are good too because of the pounce attack that they have, or even Barons. So when we go back outside to the big fight, it has to be a little more, but tougher. You know, more pain elementals and just insanity, extra hazards when you go back out to that fight to really make it worthwhile. When we go inside to the big quad damage arena, before you get the quad, I really think this is going to be a recurring theme, air attacks. When you look out over that ocean, there's so much you can put out there. Extra hazards and things here, and we see that the turrets have been buffed a little bit here, just saying. But being that it's such a wide open arena, you go up and down the verticality of this. You don't want to go through the middle because of the fire pipes. Extra hazards you could put in there, the floor. This arena really calls for you to go to the top, to the bottom, back and forth. So if we had some spirited enemies in here to knock off your mobility, kind of push you. Now I want to see some heavies used that aren't typically used as spirits. Give me a spirited cacodemon or a knight or even a mancubus. Just something to change it up from what we usually see as in, you know, spirited marauders, barons. Give me something different that is not as oppressive and insane as a baron this early on, but it's still enough to make you think twice, like a caco. Especially with all the air time and air room to make a difference there. I know we might be limited in this next one, but Meathook platforming would be awesome here. Now, there are ways to do this. I'm sure maybe we could work it out without nodes, but just having a different approach, like how World Spear takes you backwards through the map, doing that with Atlantica would be awesome. Like, how cool would it be to switch around the ways? Just did you like it when World Spear did that? You gotta let me know. Seriously, I wish Atlantica would do that too. When we go to the Archvile Electro Room, you gotta have something. I wonder if they'd have extra hazards. I don't know what they could put in to be extra because you already have the floor, unless they change the floor into something else. Again, more area denial like Cyber Mancubi would be nice there. Having an Archvile is a good choice, but whenever he's in the base map on the edge of the bridge, it's just not enough because you can really just set up a kill for him and knock him out that way. You have to make these enemies tricky and really make it different than the base experience. That way, it feels a whole, like a whole new level, like a whole brand new thing. When we get to the big outside areas, the Meathook platforming would be awesome to have over the ocean. Or even, somehow, I don't know if this would work at all, but work with me here. A fight over the ocean. I don't know, that just sounds really cool. Like a fight on a ship. What if we could go out on the ocean to an Atlantican ship and fight on that? Like pirates shooting across the ocean at the other, like demons on the other side playing pirates, just shooting cannonball hazards at us. I don't actually know about that. But just something on the ocean would be so cool with the waves and the interactive environments and Meathook nodes to go from one ship to the other and moving ships and... Oh, dude, I have to have this in the level. Don't you think so? When we get to the big outside arena, again, air is going to be a huge point. Now, it's important where you place the air. You don't want the air over in a cramped corner of the arena, gone somewhere, hiding out. You want it over the ocean. Use the environment to your advantage and place them as a threat, a tough part to get over there. Now, it would be really cool if there's an extra platform to stand on out over in the middle. Maybe they could put an extra platform with a turret on it. You destroy the turret, use the cacos to Meathook, fling over to that platform, and you have a whole other area that you can fight this arena from. Not only are you in the actual arena itself, but you're on the other side in a whole new geo and environment to do your battle on, using the enemies to go back and forth between each. Well, maybe have another way over there too, but I really think that would be a sweet idea. And of course we need armored barons because, hey, they're armored barons. Now, I would also want to have a master slayer gate, as I have talked about plenty of times before, but I did not dare to try the one in this mod since it's super hard and it's about an hour and a half without a checkpoint. Holy crap. Okay, maybe not that hard in a master gate, right? Let me know what you think in the comments also. So the small marauder room, this one is so cramped and tight. I wonder what they could do. I can see id placing a little hazard in the middle that lights up red and then goes back to blue and then red. I can see that happening. I can also see a tentacle popping up out of the ground at a few different places in the room. Maybe at spots where you wouldn't expect it, has some of the extra tentacle holes. Randomize the tentacles if you could, which I know that's not possible, but you gotta work with me here. And maybe a giant tentacle, who knows? I don't think that would actually work, but it would be pretty funny. Buffed Marauder, I can see them doing that. I can see them doing Possessed Marauder. I see them doing doubles. I can see them doing really different things, so it's not just the same old as a regular Marauder. Either way, I think that room would be able to have some stuff to work on as well. When it comes to the Onslaught Overdrive room, you gotta have something out in the air, of course, again, and just really spice that arena up. I mean, just with any of these arenas, give us something that we have never seen before. Give us stuff that we never even thought that we could put into the game. Like crazy things, the Mars Core turrets that weren't assets in the base game. Cool things like that. So when we go to the dive room, you want to make sure there are hazards, of course, but not annoying hazards. See, the thing about having hazards in a level, you want to make them make you think, but you don't want to make them obnoxious and take away from the fun zone. Hazards that slow you down too much, like the Bloodmaker or Cruciform attack, you got to watch out for those. Make sure those are cleverly and smartly placed. They are used in World Spear Master level, but if you have the wrong enemies in that room that don't jive or mesh well with those hazards, then you're going to have a bad time. Like, you don't want to have Bloodmakers spammed up in a room with the slowing hazard on top of that. It's just the same thing, and it's just too much. So a little bit of variety would be really sweet. And this room we have to have. I swear to you we do. It's the cutscene room before you dive down. This was not used in the regular level. It's a perfectly good arena. Have a Meathook node over the middle to go flying around, even though those aren't in Tag 1. Or just have a stationary Cacodemon that just sits there and can't die, and he is your Meathook node. Well, hey, how about that? I just thought of that. Put a Cacodemon there, let him shoot you, a Meathook node that fights you back. I'll have an inspiration behind that. We'll talk about that another day. And just using that room would be great, because we never saw it before. Again, give us things we've never seen in these master levels. Really change it up in the direction we can go in. This is the perfect room for that, as long as it's designed well. The area in the middle, I don't know, maybe I would kind of cut that out a little bit as it's all water. They never intended us to fight there, so I can see why that's that way. The double Marauder fight has to be spiced up too. How would we do that? Double buffed is okay. Double possessed would be really crazy. And I just think that that would be more of the same. Horde mode and some of the other mods have made some really interesting things that I would like to see here. First off, the key demons, as Protest Horde Mode 2 did, to where you actually have bounty-like demons, like the new Horde Mode has, to take them out, which to actually progress the level, which would be really cool. It's already an existing concept called trigger enemies, so I think it could totally be done. Shootable switches that unlock buff totems for you to shoot at up into the top would be really cool. And again, it all comes back to give us things we haven't seen, and hazards and ways to fight stuff that we never have before. The whole final arena would be a huge, big test, and not just a regular fight, but one that pushes us in other ways with the hazards and in the environment, as a culmination, a piece of everything coming together in one big final arena. Be sure to check out the next video here, and if you want to support the channel, click the join button below or my face on the screen to become a member. I'm Allstin, thanks for watching.